It's Vanessa from the Crafty Gemini YouTube channel. Today I'm back with another ThreadBanger exclusive where I'm going to be teaching you how to make So to make our little wallet today, here are the materials you're going to need. I'm using felt because it doesn't fray and it has a nice body to it. You can buy it at your local craft store or fabric shop. They sell it in these little sheets like this. They're super inexpensive, maybe like 20 cents each or something like that. And so we're starting off with a few pieces of craft felt. Here I'll go over the measurements in a second. Other supplies you'll need are a rotary cutter with the corresponding mat, some rulers, pins, whatever thread you're going to be using, and a pencil to mark a few lines with. For the felt, we're going to need two rectangular pieces that measure 9.5 inches by 4 inches. Then for the smaller ones, these are gonna make up our pockets, the little pockets you see here. So four of these pieces need to measure 3.75 inches by 2 inches. And then the smaller one, which goes here in the center, that one only measures 3.75 by 1.5 inches. So let's get started. So I'm using different colored felt pieces because I kind of like this look. Now, first thing we're going to do is grab the two big rectangular pieces, determine which one you want to be the outside of your wallet, okay? And then which one you want to be just the background of where the pockets go. So I'm gonna do a yellow background and the inside is gonna be the pink. So whatever one you decide to have on the inside, I want you to trim away 1/4 inch off the long side of it. So I'll just lay it here. And that's 1/4 inch there. I just like to do this so that it gives me basically a little bit of a lip to grab onto when you're going to open this up to get your dollar bills, okay? So now that we have that, we can set this aside. Now we start with the actual pocket pieces. We're gonna be working with the inside since the pocket tabs are sewn onto the inside. Layer one on top of the other, and the one that's underneath, you want it to be poking out about 1/4 inch from here. So like that. The flat edge here needs to match up with the raw edge on the left side or the right side, whichever one you're doing first. And I'm gonna put some pins there just to help hold this in place. What you wanna do now is go to your machine and you can use any stitch you want. You can do a straight stitch, zigzag, blanket stitch, whatever decorative stitches your machine has, because remember, this fabric, this craft felt doesn't fray. So you don't even have to finish off the edges, right? You can just stitch it down with whatever stitch you want. So I'm gonna start up here, remember to backstitch at the beginning and when we get to the end. We're gonna backstitch here, go through all three layers, pivot on the corners, of course, and we're gonna come back around here and then backstitch as well. And the reason I'm doing one side and I'm not going ahead and doing all of them at the same time is because since when we sew, things tend to move a little bit on you. I want to sew this one down first, make sure that then I'm folding my wallet in thirds and we're gonna mark these creases, so that we can make sure when we sew in the rest of the pocket tabs, everything is symmetrical and it matches up nicely. So here are my first two little pocket tabs sewn down. I used just a straight stitch and there's no actual seam allowance. I just stayed maybe about 1/8 inch or so away from the edges. You wanna stay nice and close to the edges because I've measured this out so you can fit the standard size credit cards and driver's license and things like that in there. So you don't wanna come in too far or else your cards won't fit in there. So another way to do it is to put in your cards and audition it before you start sewing. Now the next pocket we're going to sew is going to be the center one. And to do that, so you make sure you get it where you want it, we're going to fold this in thirds. Notice I'm not folding right here at the edge, right? We want to give space for the credit cards or the licenses to stick out and then fold. And if you kind of just fold the fabric like this, it'll fold on its own kind of where it wants to be. And so you want it in equal thirds, just like this. And you want to make a little crease. Here's going to be the center one. So kind of just scratch it with your hand a little bit. Try not to stretch out the felt too much. But you can see I have a nice line there. And so I'm going to come in about 1/4 inch to the right of that line, okay? Because whatever ID I put in this pocket, I want it to have some clearance room for when I fold it closed. So I've lightly made a little line there just so I can help eyeball it and tell myself this is where I need to sew this pocket. And again, place a few pins. If you notice that the felt layers, once you start getting around the bulkier parts, if it's moving too much on you, feel free to put on if you have a walking foot on your machine, or also you can lessen the presser foot tension on your machine. And you can check your user manual for instructions on how to do that. This one, I'm going to take it to my machine now, and I'm going to stitch down three sides, back stitching at the beginning, going to the corners to pivot, and back tacking at the end as well, so I can have an opening here. Okay, so I stitched this one down. Now I just have to put the remaining two little pocket flaps here. Remember, one on top of the other, the bottom one creeping out about a quarter of an inch from the top one. The top one's edge gets matched up with the raw edge here. It's the exact same thing we did on this side. I'm gonna place a few pins, and then again, to your sewing machine, stitch on three sides, back stitch at the beginning and at the ends. And after you're done with the center portion, all you have left to do is basically embellish the outside part. So if there is something that you want to put on it, go ahead and do that now. I just cut out a few extra pieces of felt and made like a little cupcake here. Stitch around it, whatever kind of embellishment you want to do, do it now before we sew it together. It'll make things a lot easier for you. Then you're going to lay it with the pretty side facing down. That's the outside. Then the inside is going to go here. And we're going to place quite a few pins because you can see it's going to get quite bulky here. If you're not using a walking foot, go ahead and put a lot of pins and take your time as you go around. I'm going to place some pins here because we're going to sew on three sides. So up here, I'm going to backstitch, come down and around. You can choose any stitch you want, but I would stay about an eighth of an inch seam allowance in from the edges. I'll probably use a blanket stitch because it encases the edge, even though this fabric, this felt, doesn't fray. But you can see it gives it a nice clean finish like this. And so I'm just going to put my pins and finish it up. Once that's done, we have our wallet here. We have the opening for the bills and five slots for cards and IDs. I like to leave mine like this with no closure and just slip it in a pocket in my purse or in my back pocket. If you wanted to finish it off with a closure, there's tons of different ways to do it. But one way to do it after the wallet is complete is by getting those sticky Velcro dots that have a really strong tack on the back of them, and you don't even have to sew them on. You can put one here and here. Obviously, you would measure before you did it, and then you would have your closure. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, go ahead and hit it with a thumbs up, share it across the different social media sites, and of course, remember to head on over to my channel and subscribe so you won't miss out on any of my new video tutorials. I'll see you next time, and thanks for watching.